The share price for Scientech is up or has gained around nearly 90% this year. You look at the broader Taiwan benchmark and it's up around 25% this year. What is, or what explains that outperformance that we've seen?
We are lucky in this AI industry. We benefit from the equipment that we build, the process that we develop with customers together to enable AI process. So that's why our investors value Scientech as a potential company who can really contribute in this industry.
And what sort of demand are you seeing? What's your outlook for demand for your equipment toward the end of this year, but next year as well?
The growth will be substantial for next few years. The increase, the growth rate, which will be much, much higher than 8%.
Can you give the number?
The equipment that we sold to them probably increase two or three times a year. It is possible. And so it is also benefit the Scientech from their revenue.
Do you see any risk to that outlook?
From my personal perspective, this booming of AI industry just begin. There's a lot of application I do expect will coming out pretty soon. So that's why Jensen Huang, some time ago, he say the overall market of AI will reach 100 trillion at some point in the next probably few years.
We're seeing a lot of Taiwanese companies that are choosing to expand abroad. Do you see any sort of concentration risk from choosing to focus your attentions here?
Of course, definitely we will try to evaluate alternative locations, either for the R&D, for the manufacturing. Internally, this is under our processing.
Speaking more broadly now, what has been really capturing a lot of attention in the chip equipment manufacturer space or chip equipment provider space is the measures that we're seeing applied on Tokyo Electron and ASML and yes. Restricting sales of certain equipment to mainland China. That risk of tariffs or being prevented from selling to the Chinese market, is that something that concerns you or Scientech as a business?
My direct answer to you is no, because the equipment that we built mainly for packaging applications, and the packaging applications is not included in this limitation.
Do you see that risk ever appearing in the future? Is it something that you're looking at closely?
We all know the advanced packaging is becoming more critical every day. Most likely it will happen, but who knows?